Welcome on ETV. In this video, I will show you how to use Substance Painter texture directly inside Marvelous Designer on your clothes. So for this, you need to go inside Blender or ZBrush, if you got ZBrush. So let's go. Let me show you, it's pretty easy and fast. So I start ZBrush first. I go inside right here, Tools, and I choose 3D Plane. I draw it like this, go to Edit Mode, okay. Convert to Polymesh 3D, that's it. Now turn Polyframe View on. And I got this. Now, the only thing I need to do is to go inside Coordinate Texture, right here. Go to Create, and I just gonna choose UV Plane. That's it. Here, in Volumes, I can go to 0 and push Morphing UV. Okay, Morphing UV again. And now I can use this and I can export it as FBX or OBJ. For this one, I will use it as OBJ. So export and I will name it. I will name it Texture TIFF, texture TIFF, and save it. Now, the only thing you need to do is to load Substance Painter. And what we are going to do is simply steal the texture from Substance Painter and using it inside Marvelous Designer. So for that, go to File, New, 4K, OpenGL, OK, Select. Select texture TIFF and OK. And you get this, a simple plane. OK, but now what can I do with these things? It's simple. Look, I already done it before this video and I will show you how it works. So we're gonna use a texture to hazard, maybe. I need something with a nice look. Maybe this thing. Look, I take it and I put it inside. So I got this. Okay? And now the only things I need to do is to activate color, metal, roughness, normal, and 8. Okay? It's inside. No problem. So go back to File. At this time, you can save as, and you can simply choose texture TIFF. This is the same in French. So you can just save as a Substance Painter project, and you can come back every time you want and load it every time you want and choose every texture you get and put inside. Okay. So now go to back to File, go back to Export Texture. You need to choose the best resolution as possible, so 4K, okay, export. And for this texture, this is just a simple example. So let the computer finish to export all the texture, the five here, okay. It's taking sometimes because it's in 4K, so go to Open Folder. You got this, okay? And now what you need to do is remember the name. The name of this texture is Macro UL. So right click, New File, New Folder, sorry. This is Macro UL. Take all the five colors. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. You get two normals. So take and put it inside macro hull folder. Okay? Now you can close Substance Painter. I will close me because I already have this, so disregard for me. And now what we are going to do, inside Character Creator, I'm gonna take this sweatshirt I made in the previous video, okay? And I'm gonna change the texture of the sweat. So for that, first, I go inside Modify and Materials. If you've seen the previous video of the making of this clothes, I made the texture directly inside Substance Painter. This is a Marvelous Designer clothes, but this is a Substance Painter texture. Okay, so now I will load the project as a Marvelous Designer file. So this is this one, AF Sweatshirt 1. So let's load it. And it's loaded. Okay, so I am here with my finished Marvelous Designer clothes, but I don't have any texture, I just have some color to see which is the principal, which is the secondary. Okay, now I'm gonna put texture on it. So it's simple, I choose the principal, this is the gray part of the clothes, and here get texture and normal map. So I open my folder macro rules I just made before, and I just put simply in texture base color right here, and in just right here normal map, I'm gonna choose normal map OpenGL and just drag on it like this. As you can see, we got the texture on the clothes directly inside Marvelous Designer. If you want, you can change the roughness. Let me try this thing. Just right here, inside roughness, you get intensity and you get map. You can choose map. You get a new option just right here. So open your folder and choose the roughness map. This is this one, and drag just here on it, and you get the roughness map inside as. And as you can see here, we got the reflection on the clothes, and this is not the good color because my color here is in gray, so I need to change it to white. So click on color and choose white. Pick in this one, that's it, and we got the texture on it. And transformation, normal map, roughness map, texture, okay, all is good. Now, if you want, you can change just right here in T-type. This is Fabric Mate. You can change to Fabric Shiny to get more reflection on it. Fabric Velvet, as you can see, you can change the reflection of the clothes. It's up to you to test every option, just right here, in type. Glass, this is transparent texture, so we don't need it. Leather, metal. So for this one, this is like simple metal and plastic. I think the best for this one is silk satin. Or maybe velvet. Yes, velvet seems good. And now I can change directly. Inside color, I can change the color. I want something red, like this, dark red, green, blue, maybe something light blue, Take this one. I'm going to take this one. Okay. And now I need to change the scale of the texture. So for that, I choose this one. Edit texture just right here in 2D pattern. And I will select all the fourth part here, the front face and the back face. So click on this one, keep shift key push, this one, shift keep your shift key push, this one, and now we get just this. Here you can rotate the texture like this, okay? So Ctrl Z for undo. Here you can change the size, and here, just right here, you can change the global size. Let me, this one, and this one, and change it like this. More smaller, release, and you get more smaller here. You can see the first change in the 2D pattern, and you can see the final change in the 3D view only when you release your mouse key, like this. I think it's nice, so I keep this one. I keep this on it, okay. Maybe I will change the color. I don't like this color. Maybe gray. No, not black because we don't see anything. Maybe gray, and I will remove the reflection, so I'm gonna use the Fabric Mate option. Okay, I will keep this one. Now it's time to change to use the same for the orange part. So click on secondary and just right here, texture, normal map. You just have to put the same if you want or another one. So for this one, let's go to base color, texture, normal map, OpenGL to normal map. Okay, so we got it. Gonna change the color now, so I'm gonna we are in gray, so maybe not this one, full white, not full white, maybe in black like this, it seems nice, so I'm gonna change it, and now I'm gonna select all the secondary parts, so I got this one, this one, this one, this one, here. Here, this one, this one, this one, this one, this one, and this one. And I'm just gonna change the size. Something more smaller. Okay, here I'm just gonna change my black because this is too black, so just click, and I want something more lighter like this. As you can see, I can see now my texture, okay, and now what can I do? It's simply bake the texture on the clothes. So for this, it's simple. Go back to simulation, go to UV editors. You get your UV in the 0 and 1 case, just right here. And what you need to do now is to click here, texture bake. You need to choose the best resolution as possible. So choose 4K, this is 4086 pixels. Okay, this is 4K default. This is 4K. If you are not in 4K, move it just right here, or just white the 4K size. Okay, you get diffuse, metal, normal, and roughness. Click, choose the folder where you want to save it, and click on save. And it is done. Close. So now you can export, you can go back to simulation and you can export your clothes. When it's done, you get your clothes ready inside your Interpreter 3. Is you transform your clothes into clothes, and you put your texture. So I'm gonna change the principal, and I will go where it save. So this was just right here. So it's simple. Roughness to roughness, metal to metal, diffuse to base color, texture normal to bump, and this is a normal map. And I get this. Exactly like inside the Mario Designer. And here, as you can see, we get some detail. And it creates an opacity channel. So you can remove the opacity channel if you want. You don't need opacity channel for this one. Now the secondary part in orange. So this is exactly the same. So you take the same and you put it inside. Diffuse to base color and normal map to bump. And this is normal map. And I get this. Exactly, you can remove opacity channel. And you get the same as inside Marvelous Designer. Inside Marvelous Designer, this is more lighter. So if you want something more lighter, you just have to select the base color from this one. And if you want, you go inside Adjust Color, and you can add some brightness on it to get something more brighter. Like this, maybe at 30, okay, you can change the U, the global color. Ah, it don't want, for, yes, it works. Okay, I'm gonna keep this one. Now I'm gonna choose the principal, this one. Base color, and if I want, you can choose inside diffuse color another color if you want. Maybe this one, maybe in red, orange. And if you want to use inside Marvelous Designer the texture, but if you don't want the color, you can go inside principal, and when you get your texture map just right here, click on the small arrow and check or uncheck the saturation on. So for this one, I will check. It was on, so I uncheck the desaturation on. Okay. I will do the same for the secondary. So the arrow on the texture, desaturation off. Yes, I get a best color. I will choose this one. I will use this one. So go back to UV editor. It's already ready. Go back to here, texture bake, the same folder, 4K quality, and save. I'm gonna retry this one. And it's done. So as you can see, when you put a texture on it and you click on the small left arrow, you get this option, desaturation. If you enable the desaturation, it's just gonna remove the color of the original texture. And if you want to keep the original color, you just have to stop it. Like this, and now you can go to the full white and have the original color if you want, but I will keep the one I made just before, like this. So let's put the new texture on it. So this is the principal, okay, and this is this one. So roughness, metal, diffuse, and normal OpenGL normal map. And I got it. Do the same for the secondary. This is exactly the same. Rogueness. Metallic. Diffuse to base color. And normal OpenGL to bump. And this is normal map. And that's it. This is the Marvelous Designer. And this is the Character Creator 3 result. It's more darker, so if you just want to bright all, you just have to go inside the base color attribute and add some brightness, maybe 5, and it's becoming lighter. Like this. Now, if you want to add, go back to Marvelous Designer, and I want to add something on an Nini logo inside, okay? So for this, I just have to choose Graphic 2D Pattern, just right here. I need to go inside a folder where I save my Nini logo. So I will keep the yellow one. I click on it and open. And now I need to choose which part of the clothes will be able to receive the logo. So I will choose, this is the front face, and I will make, I want it to the left. So I click on it on this one. This is the size start. So I put, I choose OK. And my logo is right here. So as you can see, now if I take edit texture, and if I choose, this is this one, transform graphic, this option, transform graphic, I choose this one, my logo, and here I can rotate if I want, like this. Okay, so go back to normal, like this one. Okay, and here I can change the size like this. More smaller or more bigger. And if I click on it, I can move it to the position I want. So let's check. Okay, more down like this. And I want something a little bigger. Maybe again. Not too much, yes. And this is the final result in the 3D view, like this. So now, do the same, simulation, UV editor. As you can see, it's already here. The same, texture bake, 4K, the folder where you want to put it after. Diffuse, metallic, normal, rogueness, okay, save. You can close this small windows right now, go back to simulation, and open the folder where it was, and you have just to, this is the principal, so you have just to re-put the new texture on it. So rogueness, metallic, diffuse, and normal OpenGL, and this is normal map. And now I get my logo directly on it. And that's it. Now let me show you directly with Marvelous Designer with exportation. Okay, so I will remove its clothes. So I delete it like this. Inside Marvelous Designer, my character is in Unreal Engine 4 pose. So inside Character Creator 3, I choose my character. Like this. Go to pose. Go to template. And this is this one. Open Unreal Engine 4. Okay. Go back to Marvelous Designer. Now all our textures are ready and are already baked. So right click on the 3D view, hide all avatar. I only got the clothes pieces I want, so I want only this one. Go back to File, Export, FBX. You can name it. So test texture, like this. Save it. And here, this is a single object. Okay. All are wild. This is thick. Yes, this is thick because we got volume on this part and this part. Centimeter da studio, okay. And you can absolute texture image fill, okay. And okay. Now go back inside character creator free, go to create accessories, and this one, test texture. And you get your clothes just right here. So the first thing, go to modify, attribute, pivot to the middle, move it to the good position. I think this is the good position. As you can see, the texture is not nice. It's because you have not put on it. So go to material. We are in traditional, this is not the good. We want PBR. So select the both, one and two. Here in shader tip, choose PBR. So it's changing the size, the shader tip to PBR, like this. And as you can see, this is not the good one, okay? So choose the principal, this is this part. Open your texture folder, and this is this one, so it's simple. Rogueness to Rogueness, Metallic to Metallic, Diffuse to Base Color, and Texture Normal to Bump, and this is Normal Map. Okay, and you can remove the Opacity Channel, you don't need it. And here, you get the in Diffuse Color. You are in gray, so you can choose full white to get the full color, like this. And do the same for the secondary. The secondary is this part right here. So you can go directly in diffuse color, full white. And now you can put your texture bake with Mario Designer inside. So roughness to roughness, metallic to metallic. Diffuse to diffuse, to base color, sorry, and normal to bump. And this is normal map. And that's it. You can remove the opacity channel, you don't need it. And we got exactly the same clothes. And it's done. You just have now to go inside attribute and change the transfer skin weight to the clothes for this one. This is default close. And that's it. This is the end of this video about texturing directly inside Marvelous Designer. As you can see, it's pretty simple and easy. And you can do the same. Oops, sorry. I move it. And you can do exactly the same with your own texture. You can choose a texture on Google, on the internet, and you can download it and you can use it as I made, just like this. And that's all. Thanks for watching and see you later. Bye bye.